Hey everybody, it's Alex with Engineering Applied. In this video, I'll be giving you a detailed overview of the split tool found in Autodesk Inventor. If you want more easy to understand and practical content like this, made by an experienced engineer like myself, make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on notifications so you don't miss out on any helpful content like this in the future. If you're looking for a specific function, check the description for timestamps. And if you don't find what you're looking for in this video, I encourage you to check out the other videos in the Autodesk Inventor series playlist because I know you'll find exactly what you need there. Let's get started. Okay, so to show you how the split command actually works, I went ahead and modeled up just a shelled out cubic structure because I want to show you how we can impact the various faces or the solid itself in its entirety with the split command. So once we're done with this, I'll show you how we can actually use this in a practical manner by starting a concept design for a ring light. Let's go ahead and mouse up to our split command under our modify section and click on that. And I want to go ahead and mention there are some requirements to use the split command. So we need our tool feature. So a tool feature can include a work plane, a 2D sketch, or surface features. And then we need our solid itself so we can pick up the faces or the solid to actually execute this command. So in our split command window at the top left, we have our properties tab. And so like our extrude command, revolve command, and a lot of the other creation commands, we can actually exit out of this tool by clicking this little X here. Okay, so let's go ahead and go back into split. Moving to the right, this little plus sign allows us to add additional menus to the command window if we choose to do so. And then here we have our advanced settings menu. Currently, there's nothing in here other than the help menu access. So if you need more information regarding this tool, you can click help and it'll take you to the Autodesk Inventor help site for this particular function. So that's really useful if you need additional information. Moving down, we can actually rename this feature on the fly by actually clicking on the word split, and then we can rename it whatever we want. So we could do custom name, okay, and then hit enter, and it'll solidify the name in that space there. And if we actually select the entities and execute this command real quick, I'll show you that in our design browser, or in our model browser rather, we see our custom name that pops up. So that's a really nice way to rename your feature and execute it all in one shot. Moving down, we have our input geometry section. So this is where we provide all of our inputs to obtain our desired output from the split command. So this first entry is our tool entry, and you know whether or not it's active by looking at this box and looking for that little thin blue line that resides at the bottom of it. So when you see the blue line, you're ready to select your tool or your reference geometry, in other words. So that would be this work plane in this particular case. So when I hover over that work plane, I can actually pick it up. Now, if this was not active, you don't see the blue line. And then if we hover over that, we can't select it. If this is the case, just click in this white box and you'll be ready to go. Now let's go ahead and actually select our tool feature, which in this case is this work plane. So I'm going to hover over it and left click, and you'll see it's highlighted in blue now, which means it's selected. Now, I'd like to take a second to discuss how to actually deselect items within this command. One way you can do it is you can hit this little X button in the tool selection window, and that will clear that entry for you. The second way you can actually deselect various entities within this command is reselecting the tool selection window by left clicking in the box to get this blue line at the bottom, which shows it's active. Okay. And then you want to hold the shift key on the keyboard. And when we do this and hover over this selection, it turns green. That means we can deselect that while holding the shift key. So I hover over it and left click while holding that shift key, and you'll see it disappears from the tool selection window. Now it's time to go ahead and select the faces that I want to split. So you can simply select one face, or you can select all faces all in one go with this all faces checkbox. So let's go ahead and pick up this one face here in the front and execute the command just to see what happens. So when I select that face and hit OK, I hover over this face, you'll see now they're split into two separate segments. But since I only selected this one face and I hover over the other ones, they're all intact, okay? So they're all one piece as they were originally intended to be. But again, we split this original face. This time we're gonna pick up the front face again, but we're gonna pick up this interface in the back. So we'll get the front face and then we'll get this interface. Hit okay. The front face is split in two like it was before. And then now on the inside, we have this interface split into two as well, but everything else is kept intact, okay? So the split feature is very simple once you understand the basic mechanics. We're back in the split command window, and this time we're going to use the all faces option. So before I select any faces here, all I have to do is go over to all faces and check this box, and it auto selects every single face in this solid model for me. So now I can just hit okay. And now you'll notice when we hover over the various faces on here, they're all split into two, both inside and outside. So if this is part of your design intent, this is an extremely quick way to achieve your desired result. Now, this time we're going to utilize the solid selection mode. So we're going to toggle that to on. So go ahead and select your tool. In this case, it's going to be our work plane. And then we're going to go over to this little green box. Okay, this is our solid selection toggle. We're going to click that once and it toggles that on. Now you'll notice we get an additional section called behavior. And this essentially controls what we do with our new solid bodies that are a result of using this command. Our first option under keep side is split the solid and keep both sides. So this does exactly what it says. So let's go ahead and try that out. We'll hit okay. And when we hover over this part, it splits every face in half. But I want you to notice something here. Let's go to our model browser and go under solid bodies. Now we have two separate solid bodies. This is extremely useful for when you're coming up with a design concept and you want to create two halves to a single body, but you only want to model up the whole body in the beginning just to get an idea of what your envelope is going to look like. Okay. So for me personally, this is how I would utilize this tool. And I encourage you to find other creative ways to employ this in your workflow, because I know there's going to be ways that you can speed that up. We're now back in our split command, and we're going to check out this second option, which splits the solid but keeps the default side. So when we click on this, we get a little red arrow that pops up. So the side that this arrow points to will actually be deleted. So that's how you know which side will be retained and which side will be deleted. So let's hit OK. We've retained the top side, and I want you to look at the solid bodies folder here. We only have a single solid left over. Now let's go ahead and take a look at our final option, which splits a solid and keeps the opposite side. So we're gonna left click on that and you'll see the arrow flip. So we're gonna lose the top half, but retain the bottom. We'll hit okay. And again, we retain the bottom, lose the top half, and we're left with a single solid body. Now we can actually change how the icons are displayed in this command window by going to this downward facing arrow and setting this to a drop-down style menu. And then here you go. Now we have our drop-down menu and we can set our parameters from this. I'm going to set it back to icons because that's what I personally prefer. Moving to the bottom right, let's go ahead and cover what the apply and create new button, or this little plus sign, does for us. So essentially what this does is it allows us to pick up a single feature, so we can pick up a single face and execute this command without closing the command window. And then we can go pick up our work feature and pick up another face. Okay, and then we can execute that but stay in the command window. So this just speeds up your workflow a little bit. And then let's go ahead and exit out of this. And now you'll see we've got our first split face and our second split face without leaving that command window in between these cycles. Now that you understand the basics of how to use the split tool, I want to show you a practical use for this tool in a design effort. Okay, so what you see in front of you is the outer envelope of a ring-like concept that we're working up here, but I want to split this into two pieces. I want to split it into a lens or a diffuser, and then I want to split it into a rear housing which supports the printed circuit board. Now I went ahead and put a work plane in this model, and we'll use this work plane to split the solid body into two pieces between the back housing and the diffuser on the front that'll snap into the housing. So I've got the outer envelope worked up in a single solid body. It's really quick to do, and it gives you a good idea of the visual representation of what this could look like, at least at a preliminary level. Let's go into the split command. We'll pick up our tool, which is our work plane here. And then I have solid mode set to on because we want to pick up this whole solid body, split it in two, and retain both sides so that we can save both sides as their own part number. And then we could tweak each part number separately and refine the design to create an actual producible part. We'll go ahead and click OK. We've executed the command. And now if we look in our solid bodies folder, we have our back section and our front section. So let's go ahead and save these two solids as separate part files. To save these as separate part files, all you have to do is right click on the solid of interest, go to make part. Okay. And then you get this window that pops up. Let's go ahead and rename the part. I'll name it rear housing. And then we want it to be a standard part file. You pick your file location, your BOM structure or your bill of material structure. Okay. And then we have the option for placing this part in an assembly as well. But in this case, I actually don't want to do that. So I'm going to uncheck this box and we're just going to hit okay. And when we do that, we get our new part file. You'll see it's named rear housing. And then we can go ahead and start tweaking this design and getting it where we want it to be to have a producible part. Now let's go ahead and do this for the diffuser. So we're gonna right click on solid three, go to make part. We're gonna rename this. I'm just gonna call it lens, okay? We want it to be a standard part file. This location is correct. And we want to uncheck the assembly option and we want to hit OK. Now, one thing I want to note here is that it's actually not saved yet. What you have to do from this point is you have to hit the save button and it'll come up with this window that says, hey, this hasn't been saved yet. It's on the initial save state. You just want to hit OK. And then now if we were to go into that file folder, this part file is now saved and secure. That's all for this segment of the Autodesk Inventor part creation module, where I gave you a detailed overview of the split tool. I really hope that you found this tutorial to be helpful and that you put what you've learned into practice so you can continue developing your skills as you work your way through these lessons. Also, before you watch the next video in the series, make sure you subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications to stay up to date on future content that will help you create the future you want for yourself. And of course, don't hesitate to leave a comment or reach out via my website contact page and let me know if there's anything else you'd like to learn about or see on this channel. I really appreciate you choosing to stop by and learn with me, and I'll see you again soon.